Hey, Molly, you seen my hammer anyplace? I gotta have my hammer. You seen my hammer with the...
No, dearie, not since you laid it down last June. Where did you...
Oh, I know. I put it right here in the hall closet.
No, McGee, don't open that box.
Hammer.
Yes, it's Fibber McGee and Molly. Every night, Monday through Friday, NBC brings you the Fibber McGee and Molly program, transcribed, written by Phil Leslie and directed by Max Hutto. Meet the safe driver. If you know what makes him stay alive on the highways, you may be able to follow his good example. He's not too hard to find. You can always spot him by the way he drives. He shows courtesy for other drivers by signaling turns and giving them the benefit of any doubt. He knows that speed is his greatest enemy, so he slows down at night, in bad weather, in crowded traffic, and on narrow roads. He knows and obeys the laws written to help save his life. And most important of all, he drives as though the country's highway accident problem is his personal problem, which it is. Remember, few accidents happen with safe drivers. Are you one of them?
Tackle box. Stuffed salmon. Gotta varnish that salmon one of these days. Ah, my old mandolin. And that's it. No hammer.
I found it, dearie. Here it is in the fruit bowl.
Oh, that's where I left my hammer. Give me it, will you? I got work to do today. I'm turning over a new leaf.
With a hammer? What leaf? The one on the dining room table?
I simply mean, my dear, that I have dedicated today to fixing things. I'm going to clean up all the little odd chores that you begged me to do around the house today.
Well, hallelujah.
Betcha. Oh, I'll admit that I've been kind of prone to put things off this summer.
You've been kind of prone all summer, I'll admit that. In the hammock, mostly.
Ah, but it's going to be different from now on. You're talking to the new McGee, kiddo. A McGee that's full of pepper, energy, ambition, modesty, and a high sense of responsibility. The old McGee is gone.
We'll get him back here. This new one scares me to death.
You love it. You know what I'm going to do first?
Rest a while?
No. The first thing I'm going to do is hang Aunt Sarah's picture back up there on the wall where I took it down from. The time I had to pull the nail it was hung on and used it to tighten the horns on my moose head when they come loose the night Uncle Dennis tried to chin himself on him to prove he could, but he couldn't.
I remember that night. He tried so hard.
One reason he couldn't chin himself is on account of because he's got no chin.
No.
Oh, yeah. His lower lip slopes right into his collar. So hand me Aunt Sarah's picture off the piano there, and I'll get busy.
Oh, dear, now it starts. Yes. Come in. Oh, Dr. Gamble, do come in, Doctor.
Hiya, Molly. Hello, sonny boy.
Well, 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 if it isn't Dr. George Gamble, U.D.
You mean M.D.
I mean U.D., the Undertaker's Delight.
Oh, McGee. Pay no attention to him, Doctor.
Oh, it's always a pleasure to see him again, Molly. To listen to that sparkling, witty dialogue from that brilliant mind of his.
Oh, sure.
I'd be a happy man if I had your brains, McGee.
Thank you, Doctor.
In a jar of alcohol.
Very amusing, Fatso, very amusing. But don't stand there, lard bucket. Pull up a sofa and set a spell. Well, what'd you do all summer, besides put on 50 pounds or so?
Well, the doctor doesn't look any heavier to me, McGee. Are you, Doctor?
No, as a matter of fact, Molly, I lost a few pounds this summer.
Good for you.
For a few days, that is. Found them later, though. They'd slipped down into my vest.
They're still there, too. Well, you kids go ahead and gab a while. I got work to do here.
He's cleaning up a few little chores for me, Doctor.
Yep, first thing I got to do is hang this picture of Molly's Aunt Sarah's up. Get a load of this chromo, will you, Fatso? You ever see a puss like that?
Well, I must...
Looks like something a nearsighted duck hunter just shot a broom out from under, don't she?
Now, McGee, don't start on Aunt Sarah.
Oh,
well,
no.
She seems to be a very nice-looking woman, Molly. Shouldn't have had the picture taken when she wasn't well, though. She's obviously in considerable pain.
Pain? Why, she's smiling, Doc.
Oh?
Why, when she turns on her flashiest smile, looks like she's getting rid of an olive pit. Why, she's the type
of... Well, McGee, that's enough about Aunt Sarah.
Okay.
She's really a very sweet person, Doctor.
That wealthy aunt, is it?
Oh, that's the one. Loaded. She's richer than cream gravy, healthy as a horse, and tighter than a bullfighter's pants. If Aunt Sarah can't take it with her, she'll hide it someplace, believe you me. Oh, you gotta go, Doc?
Don't rush off, Doctor.
Oh, thanks, but I'd better get along, Molly. I've got to stop by and see a little orphan friend of mine.
Oh?
I promised to take her to a movie this afternoon.
Oh, isn't that nice, a little orphan?
She's the cutest little thing you ever saw, Molly. And just as cheerful as can be.
Well.
No parents or anything. So I've been trying to brighten up her life a little bit.
Well, now, that's pretty darn swell of you, Doc.
Yes, it is.
Taking time from your busy work to bring a little happiness to an orphan child. How old is she, Doc?
32, and a beauty. See you later, kids.
Heavenly days, you don't suppose Cupid took a shot and hit the doctor this summer?
He couldn't shoot at him and miss, that's for sure. Well, hold this pitcher now while I drive a nail here. Uh-oh.
What's the matter?
Ah, the hammer handle's loose. Set the pitcher down. I'll run and get my toolbox out of the basement and tighten this hammer.
It once seemed that everyone in America was named Smith, Jones, or Brown. But that was a long time ago, and the chances are quite good now that the next person you meet will be Mr. Cohen or Miss Perotti or Mrs. Schumann. Perhaps because so many Americans have roots in the countries of the old world, we're anxious to help those in Europe and Asia who are living in need or who are actually starving. That's where CARE comes in. For $6.95, CARE delivers a new budget food package in 14 European countries. Or for $10, CARE delivers baby food, knitting yarn, or a pure wool blanket. If your name is Smith, Jones, or Brown, and you don't know anyone in the war-ravaged countries, CARE will choose a needy family for you, and you'll very likely hear from them after they've received your package. Just send $10 or $6.95 to CARE, New York.
There was a little brook trout, didn't he daydream by the hour? He dreamed that he went fishing and caught Mr. Eisenhower. Oh, the monkey and the coat.
McGee, did you get the picture hung yet? Because...
Not yet, Molly. I got to tighten the hammer handle first.
I thought you did that. You said you had something in your toolbox to fix it with.
Well, the toolbox lid is jammed. Lock's busted. I'll have to get my screwdriver and pry the lid off, so...
Hold everything, dearie. Yeah. You know, this is getting to be just like Tuesday nights. You know that, don't you?
It better be. Well, come in.
Oh, hello, Mr.
Oh, hi, Wimp. Come in, boy.
Hello, folks.
We haven't seen you for months, Mr. Wimple. Have a nice summer.
Oh, just peachy, Mrs. McGee. Sweetie Face and I...
Who, Wimp?
Sweetie Face, my big old wife.
Oh.
Sweetie Face wanted to go to the seashore for the summer, and I wanted to go to the mountains. We couldn't agree, so I said, "Dear," I said, "I'll get a coin and flip you for it."
Fair enough.
But she said, "No, Wallace, I'll flip you for it," and she did. Flipped me over her shoulder and out the window. And I ran through the garage and down the alley and took a bus to Yellowstone National Park. It was lovely.
Yeah, we've seen it.
In newsreels. Did you see the geyser, Mr. Wimple?
Oh, yes. Old Faithful Geyser. That's an amazing...
No, Wallace, no. Old Faithful, they call it. Not Faithful.
Did you ever lean over it when it went off, Mr. McGee?
Touché.
My goodness. I got my whole face full of Old Faithful, all right. But I almost forgot what I came by for.
What?
Well, I wrote a sort of a welcome back poem for you and Mrs. McGee.
A poem for us? Well, now, isn't that nice, McGee?
I don't know. I haven't heard it yet.
I'll read it to you. I call it... Welcome back to Mr. and Mrs. McGee, who are going to be heard over this network every night, Monday through Friday, inclusive.
That don't rhyme.
That was just the title, Mr. McGee. The poem goes, Welcome to Mr. and Mrs. McGee, back again on NBC. As I look ahead, it makes me shriek. What'll you do 5 times a week? Goodbye now.
And then he walks out.
You know, that's a pretty good question at that.
Yeah, well, maybe I can get back to work here now. Where was I?
Well, you were about to hang Aunt Sarah's picture.
Oh, yeah.
But the hammer handle is loose, so you got the toolbox to get a metal wedge to tighten the hammer handle.
Oh, yeah, and the toolbox lid is stuck, and I got to have the screwdriver to pry it open to get the wedge to tighten. Okay, I'll take it from there, Tootsie.
Good.
Now, let me see once. Where was I? Oh, where'd I put that screwdriver? Screwdriver. Oh, I know. It's in the desk drawer, right where it's handy.
Well, good luck with it, dearie. I want to go put some potatoes on for dinner, so keep at it now, will you?
Okay, Tootsie. Ah, there goes a good kid. And lucky, too. I can't think just why she's so lucky at the moment, but I...
Hi, mister. Hi.
Well.
It's me, Teeny.
My gosh, Teeny. Come on in, sis. Park the frame. Pull up an ottoman to rest your bottom on.
Gee, mister, you haven't changed a bit, have you?
Well, what you been doing, sis? What's new? Give me a rundown on the latest developments in the lollipop and hopscotch set.
Oh, well, I went to camp this summer.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And Willie Toops had the chickle pox. And my little dog, Margaret, he had a kitten. And...
Hold it.
Hmm?
Your dog had what?
My little dog, Margaret, he had a kitten.
No, Teeny. You're a little biologically confused here. Dogs don't have kittens.
My dog did, I betcha.
What?
He had a little bitty kitten up a telephone pole, and he wouldn't let him down, so my daddy got a stick.
Okay. How's school? You like it this year?
Oh, sure. It's just wonderful, mister.
Mm-hmm.
We got a new teacher, and her name is Miss Matthews.
Oh, Miss Fiditch is gone, huh?
Yeah, well, her name is Miss Matthews, and she's teaching us all kinds of arts and crafts, like making baskets out of grass. And making ashtrays with clay. And all kinds of crafts.
Well, that sounds mildly fascinating, sis. Well, what do you like best? Which craft?
Sure.
Hmm? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's the one I want to learn, but they don't teach that craft.
What do you mean they don't teach that craft? Don't teach witchcraft?
No.
Huh?
No, I asked the teacher. She said no.
Well,
they don't teach it.
Don't teach what?
What you said, witchcraft.
Miss
Matthews says, now children, we're going to learn arts and crafts.
Mm-hmm.
And she says, what would you like to learn best, Timmy, witchcraft?
Mm-hmm.
And I said, yes, ma'am. And she said, answer the question. And I said, I did. And she said, witchcraft. And I said, yes, ma'am, witchcraft, because if I could ride a broom...
Yeah, I know. Now, look, sis, it's been very nice talking to you, but I got a little work to do here, so if you don't mind...
Oh, gee, I'd like to stay and help you, mister, but I have to go now.
Mm-hmm.
I have to meet my mama downtown. She's down at the saloon.
Well, that's... your mother's at the saloon?
Mm-hmm. The Wistful Vista Saloon of Beauty. She's getting a haircut.
Well, that's not saloon, Teeny. That's salon, sis.
Salon, mister.
Cute kid. But that ain't getting Aunt Sarah's picture hung. I can just get this dad-ratted desk drawer open to get the screwdriver to pry the lid off the toolbox to get the thing to fix the hammer to hang the picture. I'll...
Did you get that picture hung yet? Now what?
Oh, the screwdriver I need to pry open the toolbox is in this desk drawer, and look at it. It's locked.
Well, unlock it. Do you know where the key is?
Yes.
Where?
In the toolbox.
Oh, this is ridiculous.
I'll say it is.
Fibber and Molly return in just a moment. You know, a lot of vacations start as a daydream and end as a daydream for lack of money. That needn't happen to you. You can have extra money when you need it. Simply join the payroll savings plan for buying United States savings bonds. When your bonds mature, you'll get back $4 for every $3 you invest. There's your extra money, your vacation, both guaranteed. Ask your employer about buying United States savings bonds through the payroll savings plan. Then join. Heard on tonight's transcribed program were Bill Thompson as Wallace Wimple and Arthur Q. Bryan as Dr. Gamble. The part of Teeny was played by Teeny. And here are Fibber and Molly to say...
Good night.
Good night, all.
This is John Wald reminding you that Fibber, McGee, and Molly will be back tomorrow night at the same time.
Hey, wait a minute. What do you mean tomorrow night? You mean next week. We won't be back till
You'll just be here tomorrow, Fuster. That's all. Same time.
Okay.
Good night.
Here, can you top this tonight on the NBC Radio Network?